My first words from a dear friend who taught me how to count backwards from 10 to yell God Nudor as I jumped from a chair. So that was my first, they were my first Danish words. Det er svært at sige, hvad det sværeste er. Det er mange svære ting med det danske sprog. Udtalen er svært.
Jeg bor, både.
Det tager lang tid at lære dansk, fordi danskere også taler rigtig godt engelsk. Og hvis jeg snakker med nogen fra Danmark, taler jeg altså fuld i dansk.
Ja, det er klart.
I have two fantastic teachers, and they alternate lessons. So I hear and speak from each other, but they obviously talk a lot together about what happened in the previous lesson and so forth. But we spend a lot of time, obviously, on pronunciation, because that is a very difficult part of the language. We spend a lot of time on learning new and fast expressions. We also, it's a bit multimedia, like we read the newspapers, we read historical books, we read about the royal family, we watch things that are important in Denmark's history, for example the TV series Matador. We listen to tapes, we go to exhibitions that are on around the city. So it's a really dynamic way of learning as well.
Dansk har en særlig
det er svært
at rytme.
Yes, I think it's taken a bit of time, but I also don't have anything to measure it against because I haven't learned another language. For me, Danish is the first language I've spoken other than my mother tongue. And it's always something I've dreamt of, is speaking another language.
I think there's no doubt that she has taken on Danish ears. She does have a slight Danish touch in her voice, in her accent. Perhaps it's not obvious to people from Denmark, but it's certainly obvious to us that there is a slight accent there.